It all started with a beautiful woman that I call my mother. From her, I learned the fundamentals of life, what is right and what is wrong, how to survive as an adult, so on and so forth. Being raised in a single-parent household, she made sure to inculcate certain values, spiritual and moral, into my heart. But she also helped me realize for myself the not-so-obvious facts of life, what love really is, and how to identify true beauty. Before I came along, my family was beautiful. It was one that you would dream of, a providing father, loving mother, and cherubic child. Then came me. I had a rather normal childhood. I received copious amounts of love from friends and family, and especially my mother. I had no wants as a child and was grateful for everything, my mother provided for me. I succeeded as a student and loved life. My mother and I were inseparable, and we have had each other's backs for as long as I can remember. You know, that's a funny thing about your parents. They've lived a larger portion of their life without you, but you have never spent any part of your life without them. As I grew older, I developed a very negative outlook on my life, namely my appearance. Until second grade, I had never considered the way I looked to be any different than anyone else. My mom's friends and people she didn't even know would compliment her on how she had such a beautiful chocolate baby girl. But none of these genuine observations mattered once I hit my preteen years. Middle school was a harsh time. I was teased incessantly about how dark my skin was. As was seen in a previous picture, I get my skin tone from my dad. I used to be so jealous of my sister and mom because they had the quote-unquote perfect skin tone. Not too dark, not too light, just right. You may wonder though, how a girl that seems to be so confident in herself now, her talents, her friends, and family that love her, and her outstanding, sometimes unwarranted sense of humor, could view herself in such a negative light. Well, in the sixth grade, the journey became crippling, and I remember on one occasion I actually got off of the school bus with my new pictures my mom ordered for the yearbook. I thought I was pretty. My hair was styled into a bow, my powder blue shirt was crisply ironed, my smile was wide and confident. As I pulled them out on the bus to show my seatmate, a boy snatched them out of my hand and passed them around the bus. He called me ugly. Ugly. What a word. Four letters that can make you feel so worthless. I grabbed my pictures as I was getting off of the bus. I walked home, and as soon as I saw my room, I cried. I cried hard. It was a body-shaking cry. My mom was in my room using the computer, and she was trying to calm me. She had no idea what was wrong. I shoved my ugly pictures under my bed, and I told my mom I hated the way I looked. I thought I was ugly. I realize now that for a loving parent to hear that their child thinks they're ugly is absolutely devastating. Every parent's child is a masterpiece in their eyes. I only wondered, why couldn't I be a masterpiece in the eyes of others too? Years passed and I started to realize something. I can't look to others' viewpoints of me for validation. It won't work. I have to muster up the self-esteem needed to accept and celebrate my features, to accept and celebrate my skin, to accept and celebrate even my build, to accept and celebrate me. Once I realized that, I started to come into myself. I walked with a little more bounce in my step, and I held my head a little higher. You know, confidence is not key. It's the door. You will have to open and close many of them in order to appreciate yourself and the gift of life. I just chose to keep the door of balanced confidence open. So, did you figure out the head fake? This wasn't just a lesson from my classmates and viewers and self-worth. It wasn't just to motivate you, dear friends, to value an individual beauty. It serves as a continual lesson for me in self-esteem. I battle feelings of worthlessness often, but I am learning to cope, identify, and eliminate. And for making the effort, I regard myself as an electric lady.